preparation of beta naphthalene methyl ether. Our aim is to prepare beta naphthalene methyl ether today, and this beta naphthalene methyl ether is prepared by methylation reaction. It is prepared by methylation reaction, girls. We are adding one alkyl group onto this beta naphthalene. We are adding one alkyl group, that is methyl group, onto this beta naphthalene. The H plus of this hydroxyl group is replaced. H plus, an electrophile, is replaced by CH3+. It is replaced by CH3+. It is electrophilic substitution reaction, girls. So you can tell it in two ways. One is, it can be a methylation reaction, and the other one, it can be a electrophilic substitution reaction, because H plus is replaced by CH3+, and the methylating agent in this reaction is DMSO, that is nothing but dimethyl sulfate. That is, dimethyl sulfate is acting as a methylating agent. It is providing you the methyl groups. So now we will see what all chemicals we will require. Then we will see the principle followed by the procedure. So girls, we need beta naphthol. Then we need sodium hydroxide, and we need dimethyl sulfate. So coming to the principle and the mechanism, see girls, over here we are taking beta naphthol. Beta naphthol is nothing but two benzene rings which is having one hydroxyl group. Now this is reacting with dimethyl sulfate in presence of sodium hydroxide. See what is happening. The hydroxy groups, it is replaced by methyl group, giving us beta naphthyl methyl ether. There is a linkage. How it can be called as ether? See, there is a linkage between oxygen with methyl group on one side and naphthyl group on one side. It is also called as nerolene, girls. Beta naphthyl methyl ether, it is also called as nerolene. So, and the byproduct formed over here is Na2SO4. Sodium sulfate is formed as a byproduct in this particular reaction. So we will see the mechanism in detail. So you have taken beta naphthol. Girls, beta naphthol, it is little bigly acidic in nature. So we are trying to dissolve it in a base, sodium hydroxide. So to dissolve beta naphthol, which is slightly acidic, you are taking the help of a base, that is sodium hydroxide. So you can see, girls, actually OH is nothing but O minus plus H plus. So this H plus is replaced by, how can you write NaOH? Na plus plus OH minus. So H plus is getting replaced by Na plus. To differentiate easily, I have written it in orange color, girls. See, OH, H plus is getting replaced by Na plus. So now this intermediate which is formed is reacting with this dimethyl sulfate, and see what happens. Dimethyl sulfate will give you two methyl groups. Dimethyl sulfate is giving you two methyl groups. So what happens? This CH3, it is donating one CH3 group over here and another CH3 group over here, forming beta naphthyl. Since this OH group is present on beta position, it is called as beta naphthyl. So it is giving you beta naphthyl methyl ether. Why it is ether? Because oxygen is having methyl on one side and it is having naphthyl group on another side, and sodium sulfate, it is formed as the byproduct. So girls, now everybody, principle is clear. Shall I repeat once again? We will repeat once again, girls. See, girls, what is happening in the mechanism? this butyl alcohol is reacting with sodium hydroxide. Why? It is slightly acidic. You are taking it and sodium hydroxide is the medium of reaction. You are trying to dissolve it in sodium hydroxide and H plus is getting replaced by Na plus. This intermediate, whatever is formed, is reacting with the actual methylating agent. So what happens? The Na plus on this intermediate is getting replaced by two methyl groups. It is getting replaced by the methyl group, forming the product beta naphthyl methyl ether. Otherwise, it is also called as nerolene. So, and the byproduct formed over here is Na2SO4. This reaction, it can be called as methylation reaction, because what is happening? You are adding a methyl group. Or else it is also called as electrophilic substitution reaction, because the H plus is getting replaced by CH3 plus. So when an electrophile replaces another electrophile, it is called as electrophilic substitution reaction. So this is our principle. So in the principle involved, or the reaction which is occurring in the formation of beta naphthyl methyl ether, is alkylation. Why it is alkylation? You are adding one alkyl group, that is your methyl group, and it is also called as electrophilic substitution reaction, because H plus is getting replaced by CH3 plus. Now coming to the procedure, how we have to proceed, you know, how, what is the experimental procedure, you know, you have to follow in the formation of this beta naphthyl methyl ether, or else it is also called as nerolene. So girls, what are you supposed to do? You take beta naphthol, which is slightly acidic in nature, always acid will be dissolved in a base. So you take 1 gram of beta naphthol and you are dissolving in 10 ml of 10% sodium hydroxide. 10 ml of 10% sodium hydroxide. And you are adding 1 ml of dimethyl sulfate in small quantities, girls. You know, you add, you shake it vigorously. You know, you take one burette, you fill that burette with this DMSO. You add in small quantities into that beaker and you shake it vigorously. When you shake the contents, they will get mixed up. All the reactants present in that beaker, they will get mixed up. But during this reaction, heat is evolved. So you need to maintain the temperature conditions, girls. See to that the temperature will not be more than 45 degrees centigrade. So you have to shake the contents. After all the heat is evolved, after the evolution of heat is stopped, you are supposed to heat the mixture. You are supposed to heat the mixture on a boiling water bath. Then you have to cool it. After heating any reaction mixture, you are supposed to cool it down, bring it to normal room temperature. Then you have to filter the product. After filtering the product, you can do recrystallization. So I'll repeat the procedure once again for you girls. You have to take 1 gram of beta naphthol and you are adding 10 ml of 10% NaOH and dissolving it. And you take DMSO in one burette and you add 1 ml in small quantities. You add total volume of 1 ml to that beaker and you shake the contents thoroughly. During the shaking, all the reagents present in the flask, they will get mixed up. And you have to be very careful, girls. During this process, heat is evolved, so you have to maintain the temperature conditions. Make sure the temperature will not go beyond 45 degrees centigrade. After that, when all the heat is evolved, when the evolution of heat is stopped, you have to heat the reaction mixture on a boiling water bath. Then you have to cool it. After heating it, you are supposed to cool it. Then filter the product. after filtering the product you can recrystallize the product which is formed. Is it clear, girls, everybody? In the next after you finish off, we can start with the experiment.